All right, we got a 2011 F-350 dually. This has got the 6.7 liter V8 diesel. It's like a cinnamon red color. First time I've seen this one. I think it's really sharp. And I shot the 450 dually diesel, but I've not shot the 350. This is a Lariat with a leather but no sunroof. Not the best lighting in the world, but this time of year you can only get so much for lighting. And it's not 7 below 0 right now. It's early afternoon, so won't freeze to death doing a video. Nice steps, power stroke, F-350, super duty Lariat. Ford emblem, which the 150's got even a, raised even more. This one does not have the step or a bed liner. Does have a rear sliding window. It is obviously the Super Crew, as you can see by the side. MSRP, I'll try to do this with the sun, of course, is glaring right on this part. But you're at 46. I don't know what's causing that shadowing. And your diesel adds 7. And your other charges are chrome package and the steps and a camper package. So your total is 56,635 MSRP. And I'll try to angle this so you guys can read this. Royal Red Metallic, that's what it's called. It's a nice color. Almost looks like a cinnamon red to me, but anyways. Seats do come up. Oh, this actually has a storage tray underneath it. That's an optional kit on some of them, but apparently it's in the Lariat 350. And this is something they're all doing now. Oh, it's nice having steps. They're all doing the plug in the back for the computer. Or obviously whatever, videos, whatever. Little storage area here. There's your regular car power. There's your vents for heat. Nice, very roomy.
Nice.
And this is not too light of a color. Not a big fan of the tan colors myself because the way they dirty up, but this one is a little darker. So you get your cup holders here.
And you got your little storage pockets in the doors.
Which are two-toned. Nice. Nice step. A big step, nice and wide. A lot better than those two steps. Multiple pockets in this door.
Got your mirror.
Okay, you got your Bluetooth, and you got your gauges up here. That's your full gauge panel. There's your lights, including the fogs. Oh, extended mirrors. Cool. Power extended mirrors. I don't see adjustable foot pedals, so I don't see that control. There's your full drive switch. There's another 12 volt power. CD player, radio group, climate control. No sunroof in this one. Do a double pocket up here.
And that's for your sliding back window. And that control is right there.
All right, four cups. Not sure what that's all about, but. Two in the back, don't know why you need four in the front, but I guess maybe if you have multiple drinks. Power outlet here. Oh, the sink's over there. Looking for the sink inside, but here's your sink right here. And then this is just a little change slot here. Place to put quarters and stuff. Toll booth stuff. There's your brake, trailer brake. Oh, I see, and these come out. Interesting. So that way they probably have some other optional setups that go in this area besides just cup holders. Another little recessed pocket here. Another one down here. And a lot of little places to put things. All right. Again, the sun's not helping us show off the colors real well. It's kind of washing them a little bit, but it's the best we can do this time of year. Very limited daylight. All right. Well, I guess maybe we can try to check out the... It's warm enough that I can try popping this hood. I'll have to leave the camera here for a second while I raise it, but I might as well raise it. It didn't go so badly. Sometimes they get iced up, even if I get them rinsed off for a shoot, they'll still ice up. But it was warm enough in the sun, I figured it wouldn't. This is the diesel. It's packed in there. It's like, wow, how does it... I pity the mechanics. Two batteries. I don't know if one's to that 110 setup, One, or it just takes two to crank this thing over. Maybe the last that you got, too. This will do the shocks. You see the suspension, the springs. There you have it. Actually, pretty decent truck for the price. Well, I know it's still a lot of money, but compared to the 450s and some of the higher end Lariats, the rebates and stuff, it's not too bad. And it's a lot of truck. And they are tall. I have a 350 from 2002. And they are nowhere near this high off the ground. And the front chrome grille is nowhere near this nice.